Anthony Fasano here from the Engineering Management Institute, and I'm here at the ASCE SEI Structures Congress in Orlando, and I'm happy to be joined by Alexis Clark from Hilti North America. And Alexis, thank you for joining me here, and I want to ask you a question about your career, because as engineers, you know, a lot of engineers will be doing design work in a specific niche as an engineer, but you have an interesting job with Hilti where you're actually communicating with a lot of engineers, structural engineers, on a regular basis. So for those engineers that maybe are interested in doing something like that, take us, how did you get to that point? What made you, you know, work for Hilti and work with a lot of engineers?
Absolutely. So I have always been not your stereotypical engineer. I'm big and loud and I like to talk to people. I really enjoy connecting with others. And I think all civil engineers have a really big passion to make life better for others. That's why we get into what we do. So when I was in school, I had multiple internships in different branches of civil engineering, and I really enjoyed all of them.
Okay.
But the best part of my day was turning around to my colleagues and talking to them about what we were doing. So although I really enjoyed the design aspect, and I gravitated towards forensic engineering and kind of being a little bit more investigative rather than design-oriented.
Right.
Hilti approached me my senior year of college, and I had never heard of them. I had no idea who they were, and they kind of connected the dots for me. I was a double major in German and civil engineering, and it's a Swiss company that needs engineers. So some of the things just fell into place. But more than that, they gave me the opportunity to work with concrete, which is my favorite base material. All my concrete nerds out there, I love it. And I also had the opportunity to speak to people every day and help make their lives easier.
That's great.
It was an easy fit.
And the reason I wanted to talk to Alexis about this is because I've talked to many engineers that say, well, I kind of like engineering, but I don't know that I want to do the same engineering every day. So what Alexis does, she still does a lot of technical work. I mean, you talk with a lot of engineers about specifications and things of that nature, but she also gets to use those people skills that she loves, and she gets to talk to people, and she sees all different kinds of projects and challenges on a regular basis. And so I would imagine that today you've just enjoyed Hilti. You've been there for a while. You really like it.
I love it. Yeah. So when I first joined, I was actually a technical representative. So I was a field engineer. I did engineering work. It was very consultative. So I didn't design the entire project. I would help a design engineer who was designing, for example, a multipurpose arena or a stadium or a tall building. And I would help them with those specific structural connections.
Gotcha.
I also had to train myself in the world of software, which is really interesting, something I never did in school. And there is a sales and business component to what I do. So when I was a field engineer, it was very technical. I actually just applied for my PE, so it was enough technical to where you can still get
license. That's great.
And then I recently, over the past year, took on a new role at our headquarters in technical marketing, which was very intimidating for me because I have never taken a marketing class in my life. I've never taken a business class or a finance class. And luckily, when you have an engineering degree, you have the problem solving skills to be able to, you know, at least fumble your way through. But it's been a really interesting couple of, I should say 8 months at this point, kind of learning how you structure a message to ensure that people are understanding what you're trying to get across, especially when we're speaking really, really technical topics.
Right. Trying to communicate that. And I think that last point by Alexis is a really good point in that as engineers, you have a great set of problem solving and analytical skills that you've been trained on, you know, in school that don't necessarily just have to be applied to engineering, right? They can help you excel in other areas. I mean, it's been helpful for me in growing the Institute just because the way we think, you know, I think there's something special about that. So don't think that those analytical skills only have to be applied in technical engineering problems, because they can really help you in a lot of other ways. So Alexis, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Yeah.
You're always generous with your time, and I appreciate it because I think this is something on the minds of engineers. There's a lot of job opportunities for you out there. If you look for them, like Alexis said, she's not the stereotypical engineer, but she found the job that she loves. So thank you for sharing it with us.
Absolutely. Thank you.